I'm delighted to have architect Adnan Ahmed Khan with us. He's the head of department for architecture, Seacoast University of IT and Emerging Sciences. He is an eminent architect. And thank you very much, sir, for giving us your valuable time. I hope that students will learn a lot from your knowledge. Sir, you're a successful architect. Tell us a little bit about your journey as an architect.
Thank you very much. First of all, I'm very much pleased and honored to be a part of this discussion. Architecture, as you might know, it's an art and a science, and it's full of creativity. Mm-hmm. It's dealing with people, making the life of the people easy, comfortable, creating your built environment. So you have, as an architect, you can do many things in life. There is a lot of prospects open for the architect as a professional. And then the most important thing, that architect is a job creator, not a job seeker. That's something which differentiates it from other profession. Like many other profession, they are job seekers. Architects are job creators. They are the team leader. They are people who shape up the built environment. Yes. So there are some traits which every individual have abilities, but they are not explored. Mm-hmm. They are not discovered. And there is a point in time in life that someone, some mentor need to give you some sort of direction.
Yes.
So I can recall my early age, I was good at drawing. Mm-hmm. I was good at sketching. That was a God-gifted mm-hmm. ability. And I was also good at creativity. That was also God-gifted creativity. Mm-hmm. And a mentor, a senior family friend, he advised me one day, why don't you become an architect? I never knew about architecture. Yeah. And I was more interested, and he said that, okay, I will connect you to a friend and he will give you some advice. He's an architect and he's doing so many nice projects, and he's into so many different ventures and businesses. So I happened to hold a discussion with that senior architect, and he said that this is the profession very much suitable for you.
Wow.
And I'm glad that I chose this profession, and it has endless avenues, it has endless opportunities. Mm-hmm. But one thing youth must have, that is passion.
Yeah.
That is passion to learn more, to grow, and then that is endless opportunities in this profession.
Tell us a little bit about what's next for you as an architect.
Well, as an architect, usually graduate and professional, they think that architecture is only about designing and creating buildings. Mm-hmm. It is much beyond that. It is much beyond that. It is leadership, it is social activism, it is knowing about your environment, and it is social responsibility, mm-hmm. advocacy, working for the community.
Yes.
We as a nation, we are a developing country, mm-hmm. and there is a huge scope for architects to make this nation grow, mm. to develop this nation. The developed countries, they are almost at the point of saturation, but yes. a country like Pakistan, which is developing, there is a sea of opportunities available out there for the youngsters. Mm. But unfortunately, our youngsters are always have the ambition of looking for jobs.
Mm-hmm.
That is the mindset we need to change mm. as a social activity, because unfortunately, our graduates, they think that they only have to work for the elite, a very fraction percentage of the society. It's not like that.
Mm-hmm.
We have to broaden our horizon. We must think about different ways of making the life of the marginalized communities
yes.
much more better,
mm-hmm.
so that they can have live a comfortable life, and they can have a better place, a living environment for themselves. And this architect can play tremendous roles.
Yes.
And there are many examples, even internationally and locally, some very eminent architects of Pakistan, they are working with the marginalized communities and they are helping them grow. They are teaching them the very basic skills yeah. on sustainable basis. So I think there is a sea of opportunities for the youth to come into this field and play their role in the development of the country and the nation.
And I think architects also play a huge role in preserving cultural heritage as well. I think there are lots of places, and in the restoration of those cultural places, architects do play a role. Is that right?
Absolutely, I totally agree. Architecture as a profession and architect as a professional is trained to think about multi-sectoral, multi-dimensional aspect. We have to be responsive to the built environment. Example, in a given site, if we want to design a building, we have to think in many terms about the local cultural aspects, about the environmental aspect, about the shaping up of that particular, the impact that that particular building is going to have on that particular environment for the next century or so, because building lasts 70 to 100 years. So whatever we are creating, we are making an impact. As Winston Churchill very rightly said, that we shape our buildings, thereafter the building shape us.
Absolutely.
So we have so much power that we shape our behavior, and it's not only the cultural aspect that architect is mindful of, it's the environmental, it's the sustainability factor, it's the economic factor. Whatever architects are, whatever interventions architects are doing, it will have long lasting effects over the coming generations. So architects have to be very much responsive. And one more thing very interesting, that architects have to work with a multi-sectoral trades and professional. Example, if an architect is designing a hospital, they have to work with doctors. If an architect is designing an academic building or a university or the college, have to work with academicians. Similarly, if an architect is designing an airport, have to work with the aviation people. So it's a multi-dimensional. They have the, many opportunities out there. Only you need to be passionate. You have to be more composed, and you have to be more energetic.
That's actually a very interesting segue to our next question, and this is actually a title of our series as well on career development and planning. Our hashtag that we are using is "What does it take?" So my next question is, what does it take to be a successful architect in Pakistan?
The most important thing to be a successful architect is leadership skills. And leaders, no one is born with leadership skills. That can be developed. And during the curriculum of architecture, the 5 years rigorous training, there are traits that are being developed in the students. And when they are graduates, they develop the basic skills to work in the field. Secondly, some very important thing is internships, like in different professions, like a doctor, lawyers, architects have also, it's important for them to undertake internship. And that, because there is the shift from the academia to the professional life, and architect have to work, it's mandatory for architect to work with some good firms, so that they have developed the basic skills and they work in the field. So the basic take is leadership skills, creativity, and being meticulous, meticulous. Because we have, architect have to organize a number of trades. Example, in a, any given building, there are 50 to 60 different trades. They have come together and they develop a building. So architect have to oversee each and every activity going on and have to gel them together, have to bring them together. So it's a very challenging for architects, in very, every project, every day is a new experience, and it's really a learning experience. And one can say that you leave your mark, you can see your mark, and the coming generation will see your mark in the form of a building, in the form of a built environment.
Adnan Saab, if I'm undertaking my degree in architecture, what are some of the habits and practices that will help me excel in my field?
The most important thing in architecture is creativity. As I told, said that architecture is all about creativity, problem solving, and the students who have the passion for leadership, problem solving, usually come towards this profession. Since architecture is a multidisciplinary field in which a lot of technology, building materials, working with different professionals, and it's an evolving and emerging profession. So the student have to keep themselves abreast of the latest technology. They have to keep themselves updated of the local practices, the local standards, the building codes, so many different things that are going on, and they have to interact not only with their teachers and supervisor, but also with the professions in the market, with the peer, with their peers as well, and they have to continuously learn. They have to be on a learning curve with commitment and with determination.
Right, thank you. If I am a fresh graduate of architecture, what are some of the challenges and opportunities that are in front of me?
The most important thing for a fresh graduate is to acquire a place in a firm for internship. Right. Usually what fresh graduates do, in unfortunately in this part of the world, that they tend to establish their own offices without taking that internship phase, which is not very recommendable for them. In different professions, like for doctors, for engineers, for lawyers, internship is mandatory. Similarly, for young graduates, internship is mandatory. Internship will give the young architects or the young graduates the opportunity to explore their skills, their abilities, and to explore the market, that what are the traits, what are the set of skills required in the market, and they can focus or they can gather their skills and pursue the career of their own choice. Like example, a graduate is more interested in a landscape, so can become a landscape architect or urban planner, construction manager. A graduate have leadership skill, can become a project architect, construction manager, real estate developer. So there are sea of avenues ahead of them. But internship phase is very much important, because they have to explore their abilities and then they can pursue. The second more important thing is excelling in academia as well. Only undergraduate will give them the basic skills to work in the field. But post-graduation, excelling in the field will give them more practical knowledge, more hands-on experience to excel in their profession.
If you were to give your 20-year-old self some advice, what would that advice be?
The most important aspect for an architect is to broaden their horizon. Architects, unfortunately, they work for a very small percentage of the society. Usually they work for the elite class, they work for the business class, and they work for developers in terms of building development. Social responsibility or social corporate responsibility as architect is working with the community, bringing up the communities, bringing their lifestyle in a better and making the world a better place for them to live. It is very important for the architect to broaden their horizon, work for the community, solve their problems, and they will have a broader clientele, and they will leave a mark in the society.
Adnan Saab, it was a pleasure having you. I'm sure that students know a lot more about architecture after watching this interview. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for providing this opportunity to undertake this discussion. Thank you.
Please like, share and subscribe, and stay tuned for more videos on career planning and development. Thank you.